Hey everyone, welcome back to the Top War Update. In the ongoing war between Russia and Ukraine, many advanced weapons have been used. But did you know that the Patriot Air Defense System, provided by the United States to Ukraine, actually has major weaknesses that are rarely discussed? While it's well known for intercepting ballistic missiles and fighter jets, this system isn't fully effective when it comes to facing off against Russia's Su-34 fighter jets and the conventional bombs they drop. How is it possible that a system so advanced has such weaknesses? What makes it fall short when facing these growing air threats? In this video, we're going to dive into the flaws of the Patriot system and why, even though it's effective, it can't be relied upon entirely in modern warfare. Stay tuned to find out more. Let's start with one of the biggest weaknesses of the Patriot system, intercepting conventional bombs. We all know the Su-34 is one of Russia's most used fighter jets in this conflict. Not only does it carry missiles, but it also drops FAB bombs, which can be pretty deadly. But here's the thing. Even though Patriot is highly effective against missiles and fighter jets, it's struggling when it comes to dealing with FAB bombs. The FAB bomb, or Fugasnaya Aviabomba, is a conventional bomb that relies solely on gravity to fall onto its target. It's not equipped with fancy guidance systems like GPS bombs or laser-guided bombs. That means the trajectory of the bomb is way harder to predict. While Patriot is great at intercepting threats flying in a predictable path, FAB bombs dropped from jets, like the Su-34, can be really tough to intercept. For example, the FAB-500 weighs about 500 kilograms, and it can cause significant damage to a large area. So, if a jet is able to avoid detection and release the bomb, the Patriot system has a hard time intercepting it, because the bomb's path is unpredictable. In comparison, missiles and aircraft are easier to track and intercept with more predictable flight patterns. This is where Patriot's capability falls short when dealing with bombs that have random trajectories. Now, let's talk about early detection. The Patriot system is really reliant on detecting threats early. When it comes to something like the Su-34, Patriot needs to detect and identify the threat as soon as possible in order to intercept it. But what happens if the plane flies low to avoid radar detection or uses electronic warfare to mess with radar signals? Well, detection becomes a huge challenge. Low-level flying is a technique used by these planes to fly under the radar's reach, which makes it harder for Patriot to detect them in time. Add electronic warfare into the mix, and it becomes even harder to accurately detect and track the threat. The bottom line is, Patriot's reaction speed depends heavily on how fast it can detect a threat. If the Russian Su-34 avoids radar detection or uses jamming techniques, there's not much time left to intercept the bomb that's already been dropped. And this isn't a rare scenario. The Russians have been using these tactics effectively throughout the conflict, which exposes one of the key vulnerabilities of the Patriot system. Next up, let's look at large-scale attacks. What if several Su-34 jets fly together in formation and drop bombs at the same time? The Patriot system can only handle a few threats at once. If multiple jets attack at the same time, the system will be overwhelmed. Even though the Patriot system is effective for focused threats, it struggles to handle well-coordinated airstrikes. Each Patriot unit can only handle a couple of threats at a time. So, if multiple bombs are dropped simultaneously, Patriot might intercept a few, but many will get through. Large-scale attacks, where several planes drop bombs in sync, can expose the weaknesses of this system. When you're facing a big air assault, it's clear that Patriot isn't enough on its own. The Russians have been known to coordinate their attacks in such a way that even the most advanced defense systems can struggle to keep up. Now, aside from the technical challenges, there's another big factor to consider: the cost of operation. Every time the Patriot system is used to intercept a threat, the interceptor missiles used can cost up to $3 million each. So, if you're in a prolonged conflict like Ukraine is, the costs can really add up. But it's not just about the missiles. There is also the logistics that go into keeping the system up and running. Operating the Patriot system doesn't just mean buying missiles, but also maintaining the system and training the operators, who need to be highly skilled. There's also a heavy reliance on spare parts and specialized expertise, making this system increasingly difficult to maintain in the long run. For a country in the middle of an ongoing war, these logistical challenges add another layer of difficulty. Another weakness of the Patriot system is its ability to handle evolving threats. As military technology advances, the threats evolve too. New fifth-generation stealth aircraft, like Russia's Su-57 or NATO's F-35, are harder to detect and intercept because they use stealth technology. These jets can evade traditional radar systems, which Patriot depends on. Additionally, with hypersonic missiles becoming more and more prevalent, the Patriot system needs constant upgrades to stay relevant. The technology is evolving fast, and if the Patriot system isn't kept up to date, it risks becoming obsolete when facing these new advanced threats. The growing complexity of modern air warfare means that the Patriot system, in its current form, is facing increasing difficulty keeping pace. However, it's not all bad news. The Patriot system isn't alone in the fight. Ukraine uses several other air defense systems, like the S-300, Buk, and Stinger, to create a multi-layered defense. Tactics such as electronic warfare and low-flying strategies also help Ukrainian forces avoid detection by Russian radar systems. The Patriot system is just one part of a larger air defense strategy. Without support from other systems and clever tactics, Patriot can't handle all the threats by itself. The key to effective air defense is coordination. And in the case of Ukraine, using multiple systems together creates a much stronger defense. This is why diverse air defense systems are critical, as they complement each other and cover for the Patriot's shortcomings. So, while the Patriot system is great at handling ballistic missiles and fighter jets, it does have some major weaknesses. The system struggles when it comes to intercepting conventional bombs, has heavy reliance on early detection, and comes with high operational costs. To face more complex air threats, Ukraine needs more than just Patriot. A combination of complementary air defense systems and smart tactical coordination is key to protecting the country from growing air threats. By combining different defense systems and military tactics, Ukraine is better prepared to handle even the most sophisticated and large-scale attacks. Thanks for watching. If you found this video informative, make sure to like and subscribe for more updates on Russia-Ukraine war and global air defense technologies. See you in the next video.